Welcome to Author of the Month, a look at an upcoming or veteran author. My name is Brandon, a paraprofessional at a Missouri City Branch Library. The author this time around is Sylvia Moreno Garcia, a Hispanic author known for atmospheric, character-driven novels in the genres of fantasy, horror, and historical fiction, to name a few. Let's get started. Sylvia Moreno Garcia was born in Baja California, Mexico on April 25, 1981, and raised there. Both of her parents worked at radio stations. She moved to Canada in 2004 and currently resides in Vancouver, British Columbia with family. Moreno Garcia wrote as a child, but did not restart until her family experienced financial hardships, even though her husband was working two jobs at the time. Sylvia's second language is English, and she has no formal training in composing fiction. Yet, she is an eloquent author. She writes for a myriad of genres including fantasy fiction, historical fantasy, horror, mythological fiction, thriller and suspense, urban fantasy, and sci-fi fantasy. All of Moreno Garcia's titles are geared towards adults, allowing her flexibility and expression. As of 2019, she is a columnist for The Washington Post and writes book reviews for NPR, and continues to write novels and short stories. Moreno Garcia noted in an interview for the My Bookish Ways website, "I couldn't find any work. I was very frustrated, and so I wrote something called King of Sand and Stormy Seas, and that's really when I started becoming a writer." Publishing, anthologies, and short stories. Moreno Garcia began her career publishing in various fiction magazines and books, including Exile Quarterly. She contributed short stories too and edited a few anthologies for science fiction, fantasy, and more before writing her debut novel. The author serves as publisher of Innsmouth Free Press, an imprint devoted to weird fiction. Some anthologies Moreno Garcia has contributed to include The Book of Cthulhu, Book 1, 2011, Zombie Shambling Through the Ages, 2013, Mass Mosaic, Canadian Super Stories, 2013, and Mothership, Tales from Afrofuturism and Beyond, 2013. Anthologies as an editor comprise Fractured, Tales of the Canadian Apocalypse, 2014, set in a post-apocalyptic landscape, She Walks in Shadows with Paula R. Stiles, 2015, a collection of Lovecraftian tales by women from around the world, and Nebula Awards Showcase, 2019, collected stories of winners and nominees for the award, to name a few. Debut novel. Signal to Noise tells the story of a teenage girl who learns how to cast spells using music. The novel begins in the 1980s within Mexico City. Meche, along with two friends, uses her magic to alter their social standing in school that results in a fallout between the friends. The novel jumps between the years 1988 and 2009. In the year 2009, the current/future relationship with Meche's childhood friends is explored, as well as her connection to her strange father, who has recently passed away. Moreno Garcia comments on her inspiration for the novel in an interview with My Bookish Ways, imparting that she grew up in radio cabins surrounded by broadcasting equipment and delighted in seeing the simple turn of a tape reel as a child, noting that she felt compelled to write something about music and records. She also remarked that the analog format may be foreign to the younger generation, who may see it as alien or even magical. Certainly Dark. Sylvia Moreno Garcia's follow-up novel, Certain Dark Things, centers on the unlikely alliance of a street kid and an alluring and dangerous vampire named Atil, a descendant of the Aztec, on the lam from multiple pursuers in Mexico City. The book received generally positive reviews. Library Journal reviewer Megan McArdle remarked, "The Mexican setting is a huge part of the allure of this new novel from Moreno Garcia, as are the fascinating varieties of the vampires she sets forth." The Beautiful Ones, Moreno Garcia's third title, transports the reader to the elegant city of Losail, home of Antonina Valu, our heroine, who aims to achieve a spot in high society within her first grand season by finding the right husband. In this world, telekinetic powers are normal, but Antonina is insulted for her lack of telekinetic control. A traveling, well-known telekinetic performer named Hector enters the picture and throws Antonina's world into romantic and dramatic disarray. School Library Journal writer Shelley M. Diaz shared, "Moreno Garcia adeptly captures the ecstatic highs of first love and the bitter disappointments of first heartbreak. Hints of the paranormal and dashes of adventure and feminism are subtly interwoven, making for an unforgettable work. Dreams of Space. Prime Meridian is a novella following the story of Amelia, a 25-year-old resident of Mexico City with a once-promising future who now seems destitute of opportunities, after leaving college before completing her studies to care for her sick mother. Stuck in a rhythm of stagnation, mostly due to the barriers society has erected to attain success, Amelia dreams of going to Mars, which has been colonized by humankind for some time. According to a December 2018 review on the website Space and Sorcery WordPress, Moreno depicts a lack of drive that could affect a society where opportunities are scarce and a dichotomy between the haves and the have-nots has become an insurmountable chasm, and quiet despair, a way of life. The novella Prime Meridian was funded by and originally released to backers on the crowdfunding website Indiegogo in December 2017. A wide release was available for everyone else in July 2018. Moreno Garcia visits the realm of mythology and fantasy once more in Gods of Jade and Shadow, when Castle P, Toon, a young girl from a small town, enters into a contract with the Mind God of Death to achieve her dreams of success. But there will be dire consequences if she doesn't restore the god to his rightful place on the throne. Set during the Roaring Twenties, the journey ventures through Mexico City, Arizona, the lush jungles of the Yucatan, and the Mayan underworld. Shelley M. Diaz of Library Journal expounds, lavish clothes, jazzy music, and ruminations on life, death, faith, and the cosmos combined with blood-drenched nightmares, grisly religious rituals, and road trip hijinks. An author's note in Glossary of Spanish and Nahuatl Terms further explores the source material. A worthy read. What a Thrill. Untamed Shore is Silvia Moreno Garcia's first thriller. Baja California, 1979. A young woman named Viridiana becomes intertwined with affluent American citizens living the high life. When one of them is discovered dead, Viridiana becomes wrapped in a spiral of lies and deceit in a bid to protect her friends and find the truth. The novel received positive reviews and praise for its addition of diverse voices to the crime fiction genre. Henrietta Verma of Booklist remarked, "The descriptions of Baja are uncommonly evocative of gritty reality, with poverty and desperation made plain on the page, as well as the lengths people are willing to go in order to escape. This insightful look at criminal life from the viewpoint of a sardonic yet lonely soul seems destined for more plaudits." Gothic Foray. Mexican Gothic Silvia Moreno Garcia's sixth novel is a tale of intrigue set in dazzling 1950s Mexico, following the clever, brave heroine Noemi answering a plea for help written in a letter from her newlywed cousin. In High Place, an extravagant house in the countryside, Noemi encounters her cousin's menacing husband and the enigmatic old patriarch, both remnants of wealthy lineage. Also dwelling in the looming abode is a kind yet mysterious younger son who becomes an ally to Noemi. The house holds many secrets. Some are wracked in violence and others streams of madness. Kirkus Reviews remarks, "Moreno Garcia weaves elements of Mexican folklore with themes of decay, sacrifice, and rebirth, casting a dark spell all the way to the visceral and heart-pounding finale. Fans of gothic classics like Rebecca will be enthralled as long as they don't mind a heaping dose of all-out horror." Mexican Gothic has been optioned for TV. Hulu, ABC Signature Studios, and Emilio Productions will adapt it for the small screen as a limited series. Kelly Ripa and Mark Consuelos will be producing. That's a wrap on today's video. Be sure to look for the author's books within your local Fort Bend County Library. For more information on Silvia Moreno Garcia and her titles, visit www.silviamorenogarcia.com. And for a deeper breakdown of her titles and accompanying professional reviews, explore the novelist database, which can be reached at the Fort Bend County Library's website within the section entitled Databases. Thanks for watching. Until next time.